we have seen so many different types of the classification among the animal world. Okay, so as I told you, from the porifera till the echinodermata, we have seen so many invertebrates. Then we have seen something about the hemichordata. Then we have seen something about the chordata. Then we have seen so many classes belongs to the particular chordata. Okay, as I told you, what you have to memorize over here, you have to understand the basic characters to identify each and every category belongs to the particular animal world. Okay, you can expect the questions from the basic characteristics to which you can identify the particular organism or particular category belongs to the animal kingdom. Okay, and as I told you, you have to know the major examples belongs to each and every category. And see the first question, which is not a true amphibian. Okay, and see the choices: salamander, toad, frog, and tortoise. Okay, so when you see the choices, salamander, toad, frog, tortoise, all the four can live in both in water and terrestrial environment. Okay, so that is what called amphibians. Ambi means both. Amphibians refers to they can live in both water and terrestrial form. And you have to choose which one is not a true amphibian. Okay, as I told you, in case of chordata, there are so many classes. Okay, and among the classes, two classes are reptilia and amphibian. And over here, among the four choices given for you, one belongs to reptiles, not belongs to amphibians. And you have to find out the one, that one is tortoise. Tortoise belongs to reptilia, not belongs to amphibians. Okay, and all the remaining, salamander, toad, and frog, all belongs to the amphibians. Okay, the choice answer over here is tortoise. And see the next question: the Malpighian tubes are. Okay, so this question is talking about a structure present in the lower forms of invertebrates. Okay, and the structure is called Malpighian tubes. Okay, there are choices given for you. Actually, the choices comparing in between the two phylum, Annelida and Arthropoda. Okay, insects. Insects belongs to Arthropoda. Annelids belongs to Annelida. For example, earthworm belongs to Annelida. Cockroach belongs to insects or Arthropoda. Okay, so the question is talking about the structure called Malpighian tubes. And actually, the answer choices, as I told you, comparing two phylum, Arthropoda and Annelida, and you have to choose the phylum first, then you have to choose the function next. Okay, so the correct phylum over here is belongs to Arthropoda. Malpighian tubes are always belongs to Arthropoda, so you can easily eliminate the choices belongs to Annelida. Okay, and now you have two other choices: excretory organ or respiratory organ. Okay, and the answer choice over here, the correct answer over here is excretory organs. Okay, Malpighian tubes are excretory organs of Arthropoda. In case of Annelida, nephridia is the structure which is going to involved in the excretory function. Okay, and see the next question: Ascaris larva is called. Okay, this is a straightforward question. Yeah, you should know the name of the larval form of the particular Ascaris, and rhabdidi form is the larval form of the Ascaris. Okay, see the next question: which one of the following animal possesses, okay, nerve cells but no nerves? This is what you have to understand from the particular question. There are some nerve cells but there are no nerves in the particular animal. Okay, so you can easily assume that that particular answer or that choice will be a primitive form of any animal. And see the choices: hydra, tapeworm, earthworm, and frog tadpole. Frog is the highest form. Okay, so they are on the chordata. You can easily eliminate that. And see the remaining choices: hydra, tapeworm, and earthworm. Tapeworm and earthworm, they having the primitive form of nerves. Hydra, they having only the cells of the nerve. Okay, so the answer over here, hydra. See the next question: which of the following is not a characteristics of a phylum Annelida? Okay, so as I told you, you should know thoroughly the major characteristics or major characters to identify the particular phylum. And see the choices: pseudocoelom, ventral nerve cord, closed circular system, circulatory system, and segmentation. Okay, as I told you, annelid refers to annulus. Annulus refers to ring. Okay, that means their body is made up of rings like structure or annulus like structure or segmented. Okay, so segmentation is present. This question is talking about the negative connotation, not a characteristics of. So you can easily eliminate the segmentation. Okay, and there is a, as I told you in the previous section while we are comparing the answer, earthworm. Okay, earthworm belongs to the annelida. They are having the primitive form of nerve cord. Okay, so you can easily eliminate the ventral nerve cord over here. They are having closed circulatory system also. In case of annelida, they are having the closed circulatory system also. And the answer choice over here, they are pseudocoelomates. Okay, this is not a correct answer over here. So, which one of the following is not a characteristic of the phyla annelida? Pseudocoelom is not a characteristic of annelida, because in case of annelida, they are true coelomates. Okay, so they are having true coelom in their body. Okay, this is how you have to understand the question and answer the question. Now we are going to see the next set of questions. And see the next question over here. Presence of gills in the tadpole of frog indicates that. Okay, so this question is talking about somewhat the evolutionary character or evolutionary guess, assumption. Okay, see the choices. Fish were amphibians in the past. Fish evolved from frog-like ancestors. Frogs will have gills in the future. Frogs evolved from gilled ancestor. Okay, so by common sense we can easily pick up the answer. Okay, and we can easily eliminate the answers also. Fish were amphibians in the past is may not be the correct answer, because normally the amphibians are more evolved than the fishes. So you can easily eliminate the first choice. Of course, fish evolved from the frog-like ancestor may not be the correct answer, because frogs may be evolved from the fish-like ancestor. So you can easily eliminate that one. Frogs will have gills in the future may not be the correct answer, because this is talking about the future possibility. For the future, the adaptation of the frogs may not change over here. And see the last choice over here, the frogs evolved from gilled ancestor. That is what I told you. Frogs, they have evolved from, as amphibians, they are evolved from fish-like ancestors. So this is the correct choice over here for the question. See the next question. In contrast to annelid, platyhelminthes show. Okay, and this is the type of question. It is going to compare two different phyla. They are going to compare the characteristics of two different phyla, and you have to find out the correct choice over here. To understand the particular type of question, as I told you, you should know the basic characters of each and every phylum thoroughly. And see the first question, see the first choice over here, absence of body cavity, then bilateral symmetry, radial symmetry, presence of pseudo seal. Okay, as I told you in the previous session, in case of annelida, they are having the true body cavity, they are true coelomates. Okay. So the choice over here, absence of body cavity. Okay, in contrast to annelida, platyhelminthes, they are having the absence of body cavity. In case of annelida, they are having the true body cavity. Okay, see the next question. Which one of the following group of animals reproduces only by means of sexual means? That is, only by means of sexual reproduction. Okay, and see the choices. Cnidaria, Porifera, Protozoa and Ctenophora. Okay, and as I told you in the previous session, this is talking about somewhat evolved form, and you have to eliminate the primitive forms. Okay, Cnidaria belongs to Cylindrata. This is the lowermost phylum. Okay, apart from the Porifera, this is the lowermost phylum. As I told you, Porifera is the level 1 of the particular invertebrates. Okay, and Protozoa, you can easily eliminate that. Protozoa, Porifera, Cylindrata, these three phylums are the lowermost phylum. This is a unicellular form. This is at the very primitive multicellular form, Porifera, the sponges. Cnidarians or jellyfishes, cylindrates, they are also very primitive form of the invertebrates, phylum. And the choice over here is Ctenophora. They can do the reproduction only by means of sexual means. And see the next question, the coelom. Coelom is found in between. This question is talking about what do you mean by the body cavity or true coelom. And as I told you, there are three layers of embryonic layers. Okay, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. See the choices. In between body wall and ectoderm. Body wall means endoderm. Okay, don't confuse with the term body wall. Body wall means endoderm. Okay, so body wall and ectoderm, endoderm and ectoderm, okay, both are same. Mesoderm and body wall, and meso and ectoderm. Okay, the correct choice over here, the mesoderm and body wall, the gap or the space in between the body wall and mesoderm is referred to as the coelom. Okay, this is how you have to answer the question. And now we are going to see the next set of questions. And see the next question over here. Temperature changes in the environment affects most of the animals, which are, okay. So this question is talking about a group of animals or how the animals gonna respond to the temperature in from the environment, okay. And you may attempt to choose the answer, this one, desert living, okay, because the question is talking about temperature or heat and you are going for the desert living. This may not be the correct answer. As I told you, this question is talking about the nature of the animal, how they are or how their body gonna respond to the temperature from the environment. Okay, so see the choices. There are some choices over here: poikilothermic, homeothermic and aquatic. Okay, so you can easily eliminate the aquatic. As I told you, this is not about in a water environment or in the desert environment. This is something about the nature of their animal body. And you have to choose in between the poikilothermic and the homeothermic. Okay, so in simple words, we can call that as cold-blooded animal or warm-blooded animal. Okay, so poikilothermic animal means they cannot change their body temperature based on a requirement. Okay, or they are not going to maintain the constant temperature. That is what you have to understand. And homeothermic means they are going to maintain the constant temperature throughout their lifetime. Okay, that is what you have to remember. For example, in case of human being, we are going to maintain a constant body temperature. Whatever may be the environment temperature, the environment may be very cold, the environment may be very high. We are going to maintain the constant temperature around 37 degrees centigrade. 37 degrees centigrade. Okay. And the question is talking about or asking about the temperature changes in the environment affect most of the animals, means the animal gonna change along with the environment temperature, and that belongs to the answer, the poikilothermic. That means they cannot maintain the constant temperature, they are gonna change their body temperature along with the, or the animal's body temperature gonna change along with the environment. That is what you have to understand over here. Okay, see the next question. The long bones are hollow or and connected by air passages. Okay, and from the question you can easily understand the concept. Okay, so over here, in the particular type of group of chordata, the long bones are hollow or hollow nature. In the center of the bones are hollow in nature, and they are being connected with each other, and they are being filled with air passages. Okay, so this is you can easily identify this character as a kind of adaptation. Adaptation for what? Adaptation for flying. Okay, so see the choices. Reptilia. Nowadays reptiles not gonna fly. Okay, there are some reptiles, there were some reptiles, dinosaurs, they were flying in the world, but there are no flying reptiles now. And see the choice, land vertebrates. You can easily eliminate the larger vertebrates over here. Mammals, they won't need the flying adaptation. There are some exceptions. Okay, in the mammals, bat can fly. And normally the correct choice over here is apes or bats. Okay, over here they are adapted for the flying. Over here the bones are being connected with each other by means of their passages. And see the next question. This is a direct question. sound box of birds is called. Okay, sound box or the sound producing organ or structure present in the birds are called syrinx or syrinx. Okay, so they are going to produce the sound for the birds. And see the last question over here. In protozoa such as the amoeba, the organ for osmoregulation is, okay, and this question is talking about the structure which is going to perform the osmoregulation in the particular protozoa. Protozoa, as I told you, they are very primitive form of life. Okay, and see the structures: contractile vacuole, mitochondria, nucleus and food vacuole. Okay, food vacuole, they are going to store the food, they are not going to regulate the osmosis or osmoregulation. Nucleus and mitochondria are organelles, they are not going to involved in the osmoregulation. The answer over here is contractile vacuole. Okay, they are going to involved in the osmoregulation in the protozoa such as amoeba and plasmodium. Okay, now we are going to see the next set of questions. And see the next question over here. A jawless fish which lays eggs in fresh water and whose larval stages, that is amoeocetes, after metamorphosis, that is after development, they are going to return to the ocean. Okay, so as I told you in the previous section, I told you something about the migration. Okay, so what is migration? As I told you, the moving of the particular animal from one environmental condition to the next condition, that is over here from the marine water to the fresh water. Okay, so over here the particular animal, they are going to move from the marine water to the fresh water for the reproduction and for the laying of eggs. And over there, that animal going to die in the particular fresh water. But the larval stages, as I told you over here, the hatching out of the particular eggs, they are going to mature or metamorphosis into adult. And those newly formed adult forms, they are going to return back to the original site where their parents were lived. Okay, so this is what called the migratory nature of the particular fish over here. And you have to find out the correct fish over here. Okay, the clue for you over here, the jawless fish. Okay, and over here among the choices, the choice B is a jawless fish over here, and that is going to involve the particular type of migration. Okay, so the choice over here is the B one. And see the next question. What is true about nereid, scorpion, cockroach and silverfish? Okay, here there are some animal forms given for you, and you have to find out the correct thing, or you have to find the correct statement or true something about these four animals. Okay, nereid, scorpion, cockroach and silverfish. And see the statements. They all possess dorsal heart. None of them is aquatic. All have joint paired appendages and all belongs to the same phylum. Okay, so see one by one. All have joint paired appendages. The point you have to remember over here, only the arthropoda, I told you is in the previous class, arthros means joint, poda means legs. Arthropoda refers to joint legs or joint appendages. Okay, and here you see nereid belongs to annelida. Okay, cockroach belongs to arthropoda, silverfish belongs to arthropoda, scorpion belongs to arthropoda. So annelida and arthropoda, okay, so all have joint paired appendages or all belongs to the same phylum may not be the correct answer, because there are two phylums involved over here, the nereid and arthropoda. And see the next choice. None of them is aquatic may not be the correct answer, because silverfish, they can adapt to the aquatic environment. So the correct choice over here, they all possess the dorsal heart, is the correct choice over here, because there must be some primitive heart in the annelida and arthropoda. Okay, and see the next question. The classification of porifera based on their which character? There are some characters given for you: symmetry, reproduction, spicules and branching. Okay, and spicules is the answer for you over here. Spicules is nothing but a skeleton. As I told you, there are some cartilaginous skeleton structure present in the porifera. Okay, they are going to be give the protection or the support for the porifera. Based on the structure and nature of the spicules, we can classify the porifera into three categories as we have seen in the introduction classes. Okay, so the classification of porifera is based on the spicules or skeletons. Okay, and see the final question over here. Which one of the following kinds of animals are triploblastic? Okay, triploblastic, as I told you, this is talking about the layers, three layers of the embryonic layers, three layers. Okay, so as I told you in the previous sections, the primitive forms, they are having only the two layers, and the evolved forms, somewhat evolved forms, they are having the triploblastic nature. And see the choices over here, the flatworms, sponges, tenophores and corals. Okay, and over here the sponges, tenophores and corals, they won't have the triploblastic nature. The flatworms or platyhelminths, they are having the triploblastic nature. Okay, so this is how you have to understand and answer the question. As I told you over here, all the questions you can expect from the particular unit will be directly from the characters you are going to identify, the characters you are going to use to identify the particular class or particular phylum or particular family. Okay, so you should know the major characters, the identify the particular phylum or kingdom, and major examples belongs to the particular kingdom and phylum, class or anything. Okay, so this is how you have to understand and answer the questions. From the next class we are going to see the second unit, that is the morphology and anatomy of the plants and animals.